Yeah, let's just try some things.
Okay. You know, I've been looking at the stars, you know, since I was like 7. Not only learning about all the physical and scientific attributes of celestial bodies, it's taught me how precious this place is and how much more care we should take in being here. With our biggest, baddest telescopes and cameras, as we look out in space, we're the only place where we know there's anything living. We may discover life. I think we'll discover life elsewhere in our solar system, you know, microbial life. But even still, there's not many places like the Earth for such an infrastructure of life to have arisen and thrive and survive. Past generations didn't get that perspective until the Apollo 8 mission, where it looked back and took a picture of the Earth from the moon, where you see the horizon of the moon and the Earth above it, and you say, whoa, that's the Earth? It's so small, you know, and there it is. That's it in the blackness of space. How can we be so arrogant, spending so much time designing and building bigger rocks to throw at each other? We ought to be learning how to take better care and exploring the universe together and talking as a species instead of, you know, this country, that country, this ideal. That's a lot of space to be alone in. That's what philosophically astronomy has taught me in, you know, 58 years of observing and traveling, talking to other people about this, and it's just take care of our precious place.